Lisa Welchel. You might recognize me from my time on television. For this special edition of Collector's Call, I'm staying at home, but still meeting people with the most amazing collections we can find.
I keep telling my husband there is always room for one more Mickey.
I call up experts to appraise these treasures and hope to make a deal with the collector to trade one of their precious gems for an elusive item that's been on their wish list.
You want to make the trade?
Aye, aye, aye.
Will there be a trade? It's the Collector's Call at home.
Today I'm virtually visiting Janet Estevez, whose magnificent collection of Mickey Mouse memorabilia has turned her cozy home into a mini magic kingdom.
I never thought I was going to have a Mickey Mouse collection like this. I call it a mouseum.
Janet is joined by her husband, Jose, who admits her love for the mouse actually began on their honeymoon.
I'm a Disney fan myself. When we got married, we went to Disney World for our honeymoon. That's where the Disney collecting began.
With me is Kate Martin, a certified appraiser who's agreed to make a house call and check out Janet's massive Mickey Mouse collection.
I am overwhelmed by Janet's collection. It is so finely curated. It really is a phenomenal, phenomenal representation of Mickey throughout his career.
Kate will put a price on Janet's collection and then try making a trade. One of our collector's cherished Mickey treasures for a one-of-a-kind Mickey Mouse item that Janet will have a hard time turning down. Can Kate convince Janet to give up one of her beloved Mickeys? As always, it's the collector's call.
Aye, aye, aye.
Janet, Jose, you do not know how badly I wish I were there with you in your home. You are the Guinness World Record holder for Mickey Mouse items.
That is correct.
How many items do you have that are Mickey Mouse?
14,100 something.
When did you start this collection?
The collection started in 1974. We went on our honeymoon to Disney World, and everything was Disney. It makes me happy. It brings out the little girl. I always say I'm an 8-year-old girl inside this 65-year-old body.
I don't know if you know this, Janet, but I was on the Mickey Mouse Club in the 70s, not the 50s, with Annette Funicello, not the 90s with Justin Timberlake and Britney Spears. We refer to ourselves as the Forgotten Mice, but there really was a mouse club in the 70s. I'm going to enjoy this show for very special reasons. And I just can't wait to get started to see what your first item is. So, Janet, what are you going to show us first?
First, I'm going to show you a Catherine Bauman Swarovski purse.
Tell us where you got this Catherine Bauman Mickey Mouse purse.
We were on a cruise. And when we travel, I like to buy something from Mickey Mouse things. And this is the only thing that was on the cruise for sale. My husband thought it was going to be a cheap cruise because I was not going to buy anything. And then that purse showed up. One night, this guy decided that he was going to surprise me and just bought the purse. I've had this purse for over 20 years. I have to admit that I've never used it and I never opened it.
So now, what if he had hidden something?
He would have made sure that I would open it. But honestly, I love it. So I didn't want to touch it too much.
Well, now, Janet, you're going to have to put your fingers in your ears because I have to ask him how much he paid for it. So, Jose, how much you paid for it?
I think it was $2,000, but Janet says it was probably less.
Wow. I'm impressed. You know what, Janet, you need to unplug your ears for that. You need to hear how much he loves you.
It's not the value of these things that she's interested in. It's looking at them every day. That's what makes her happy.
So, Kate, how much would that purse be worth today?
This is a fabulous piece by Catherine, and actually, you can find her Minnie Mouse purses more regularly than her Mickey. So Mickey's a little bit more rare. Sparkly, it's zhuzhy. It's definitely a wonderful piece for her to have on display because it's an attention grabber. In today's marketplace, you'd pay about $2,800 to $3,200.
Well done, Jose.
There you go.
I don't blame you for not wanting to carry that, but I do think you should just take it out every once in a while and appreciate the love.
That's right.
Okay, Janet, what do we have next?
This is a Mickey Mouse statue. It's made of resin. It's about 3.5 feet tall. It weighs like 70 pounds. We were at Hollywood Studios, and it was on the display window of one of the stores. And I thought it was a display figure, and I said, oh my gosh, I wish I had that Mickey Mouse, you know, that would look so good at home. And my daughter said, Mom, I think it's for sale. It has a price. So we just walked into the store, and I said, I need that. I want that Mickey. I want that Mickey. I want that Mickey. And so we got it. And we walked out the park holding the Mickey Mouse between my husband and I. We were just walking out of the park.
It wasn't even wrapped.
It wasn't wrapped.
We just picked it up by each arm because it was so heavy.
And we walked.
Everybody was looking at us like we were stealing something.
What was it about this Mickey Mouse statue?
It was big. It was the biggest statue I had ever seen.
So how much did you pay for it?
$850.
Okay.
So this is life-size Mickey. When we think life-size, we think as tall as we are, but he's a mouse. Only 500 of these remain. About 8 years ago, one came up for auction, and it sold for $400. And there have been two of them in the last year. And they have sold for $1,800 and $2,000, respectively. So you made a really good investment on that.
Yeah.
You think carrying out this 75-pound Mickey out of the park, you think, man, that must have been so heavy. And then you think about how many parents carry out 75-pound children out of the park every single night.
Up next on Collector's Call at Home, Janet reveals she'll stop at nothing to fill her house with Mickey Mouse.
I said I need to have this.
And later, will there be a Disney-like ending when Janet discovers what Kate brought to Trey?
I wasn't expecting this.
Collector Janet, whose house is overrun by a mouse. Joining Janet is her very supportive husband, Jose, along with our expert, Kate, who will appraise Janet's amazing Mickey Mouse collection and then entice her with a trade. But first, there's more Mickey to see.
I have this beautiful Mickey Mouse ears, signed by Annette Funicello.
Where did you get her signature?
The Hollywood Studios.
In Hollywood Studios.
They had a store, and they had these ears. I said, I need to have them.
You needed to have them, yes.
Some things you gotta have.
She grew up watching the Mickey Mouse Club, and Annette Funicello was so very special to not only her, but to Walt Disney as well.
She was the original Mouseketeer.
I loved Annette Funicello when I was a little girl. I always said that I wanted to be Annette Funicello when I grew up.
You're going to have a Mouseketeer signed ears. If you can't have Lisa Welchel, then you got to have Annette Funicello, right? How much did you have to pay for those autographed ears?
We paid $75 for them.
That is a bargain.
Back then, it was a lot of money, but yeah.
Okay. It seems like it's a great deal.
So, if you're the ultimate Mickey collector, you have to have something by Annette Funicello.
That's correct.
Lisa, I'm sorry, but she is the Mouseketeer. However, I will say, if Lisa signed a pair of ears for you, they might be slightly worth more. Because, like many sports players, they sign 1,000 of them. So, it's more about supply and demand. You paid $75 for it. They have appreciated slightly. Right now, you'd be paying about $100, $125.
Yeah. Just hypothetically speaking, if I were to have my Monday pink Who, What, Why, Where, When, and How Day ears and a picture of me wearing them, and should I fall on hard times and want to find them and sell them, how much might I get for them?
How many did you sign, Lisa? That's what's important.
Zero.
Zero?
It's not a good substitute for your IRA.
They're priceless.
That's what my grandmother would say.
I have this Ingersoll Mickey Mouse watch from 1932, maybe 1933. The company that had the license for Disney watches back in the 30s. It was given to me by a friend who came to visit us, and he fell in love with the Mickey Mouse collection, and he said, I have a very old watch, and it would be an honor for you to have it in your collection.
Any idea how much it would have cost to buy this watch at the time?
I have no idea. It is not in the best condition, but it is priceless. Not only he sent me this one, he immediately took the watch he had on, which was another Mickey Mouse watch, and he gave it to me right there.
Okay, how much would this watch have cost originally?
In the $30 range. The thing about your watch is condition. First of all, it's not working. Number two is there are two Mickeys on either side of your strap. You're missing one of the little silver Mickeys. On the secondary market, it really does hurt the value. Because of the condition of yours and without the box, we're looking like an $80 to $100 piece.
To me, it's priceless. It doesn't matter.
We're not concerned about the value of these things. It's more about the enjoyment and the memories.
And you have other watches in your collection as well?
I certainly do. I have probably over 130. All our daughters used to have Mickey Mouse watches, and when I was teaching, I had to wear a different watch every day. The students were always checking me out. Oh, I've seen that one. Oh, you have. Oh, that's a new one. Oh, Mrs. Mickey, this is a good one. They started calling me Mrs. Mickey, and it stuck, and now I'm Mrs. Mickey. Mickey Mouse record player, 1960s. I used to have this same record player back then when I was 30 years old. Takes you back to that age. And my daughter was searching the internet one time and she says, Mom, I think I found the record player you're looking for. This is exactly the one I had, the same color, the same thing, the smell, the same smell. She said, Mom, you want me to get it for you? Next thing I know, I received this beautiful package, and I was just like in heaven.
Do you have a memory of playing records on that when you were a child?
Oh, yes, I do. Every night, I would play the record and fall asleep with the record.
It just automatically brings you back to your childhood. Yeah, what are the gifts of collecting? Kate, how much would that have cost back in the 60s?
Well, under $20. Everybody watched the Mouseketeers, and everybody wanted the same record player that they had on the show.
She didn't get it because it was rare, it's because it reminded her of her childhood. It's about the nostalgia, and it is a Mickey Mouse Club item.
It was beautiful. It was just great. It still is.
This is one of those items that hasn't appreciated too greatly, but the condition of yours is really good. You're looking $50 to $75.
Mm-hmm. We did okay.
It's not about money. It's about her memories.
On Collector's Call at Home. Janet proves her love for this cartoon character cannot be contained.
You see it in person, you just go like, holy moly.
And later, is Kate's trade offer to Janet the holy grail for Mickey Mouse collectors?
I had the opportunity to work with Walt Disney himself.
So Janet, what's going through your mind right now?
Welcome back to Collector's Call at Home. Kate appraises Janet's incredible collection and then proves she's not Mickey Mousing around with her trade offer. But first, there's more mouse to see.
I have a 7-foot Mickey Mouse statue. It was made in 2010 for the All-Star Games. And they made one for the American League, for the National League, and then they made one Mickey, the same statue with the uniforms of each and every single baseball
MLB.
Team.
What a fun item. How
it
did
is.
You get it?
I got an email by mistake. All of a sudden, I gave this email with saying all of these things that he was selling. And there was a statue, and before I finished reading, I emailed the guy back, and I said, I want this Mickey Mouse statue. And then he goes, who is this? So I told him my name and who I was, and then I said, I really, really want this statue.
So she accidentally gets an email offering her the 7-foot, really one-of-a-kind Mickey statue. I'm thinking, the Mickey Mouse gods are looking out for her. So how did he get them? Did he have a few of them?
No, he collects old props from all the Disney parks and then sells them to people interested in buying them.
How much did you end up paying for it?
I paid $7,000 for it.
I think that's a good deal. Sounds like it'd be a good deal.
To me, it was a great deal.
on the foot, right?
Right. There you go.
When you see it in person, you just go like, holy moly.
This is a fabulous find. There were 36 made, one for each of the MLB teams. And then there were four All-Stars and one National League, one American League. So 36 altogether. They didn't go for public sale. And the whole reason they were produced was actually a contest. If you took a picture with each of the 36 Mickeys, you could win tickets to the All-Star game. Most of them went to their respective stadiums. And very few of them were on the open market. And a lot of them were vandalized, and so they were replaced with a new version. The only comparable that we really have is a second Red Sox that was made, so not the original. He sold for $5,500. So yours is one of a kind. He'd be somewhere in the probably $7,500 to $10,000 range. That really is the piece of her entire collection. That is a rare, rare, rare gem.
Janet, Jose, it has been such a pleasure to be with you today and to see this amazing collection. And it's brought home just so many personal memories for me. Now I'm going to ask Kate. I know it's impossible to ask you to put a valuation on this collection. Now, you're not even there. We've only seen a handful of their items, but she has over 14,000 items.
We've seen a 3-foot resin Mickey Mouse, a Swarovski crystal Mickey Mouse handbag, mouse ears autographed by Annette Funicello, a 1930s Ingersoll Mickey Mouse watch, a Mickey Mouse record player, and an MLB All-Star Mickey Mouse statue.
How much would you just ballpark guess that their entire collection is worth?
We've got 14,500 items, correct?
Close to that.
The amount of art and the amount of complete collectibles and the very odd and difficult to find one-of-a-kind items that Janet has. Let's just say that we're looking at $100 as an average. Would be anywhere in the 800,000 to 1.5 million range. I mean, you have a phenomenal, this is unbelievable.
I'm not gonna say I'm shocked. I'm just in awe.
Blows me away.
Is that kind of what you had in mind?
I cannot put a price on every single thing I have. I really can't.
That's not what's important to you. It's not about the price. It's about the love.
I don't think that they were particularly surprised by how much Kate said it was worth. I think it was about getting the world record and the luck of it. The fact that it's worth over $1 million, oh wow, that's cool too. All right, Janet, so are you ready to add perhaps one more item? Or maybe we could make a trade.
I keep telling my husband there is always room for one more, Mickey.
I agree. So on Collector's Call, we asked our expert to bring one very special item that they know that you just can't pass up. But the catch is, they're going to ask for something to trade.
I have a feeling Janet's going to turn it down.
I am very nervous. I can't part. I can't think of any Mickey that I would trade for anything.
So, Kate?
When I was a kid, the very first watch that I owned was a Mickey Mouse red banded 1970s. You happen to have something like that in your collection?
This one?
Yes, that's it!
All right, Kate, I hope you brought something really special.
Are you familiar with Floyd Norman by chance? Floyd Norman is a very, very well-known animator for Disney, and he sent something we'd like to share with you.
You know what this is? It's an original Mickey Mouse comic strip. I used to draw Mickey Mouse, and I used to write Mickey stories many, many years ago back at the Walt Disney Studio, and I was able to take Mickey Mouse on many, many exciting adventures. Not only did I have marvelous years at the Walt Disney Studios, but I had the opportunity to work with Walt Disney himself, and it doesn't get much better than that. So it's just really great being here with you on Collector's Call and being able to say congratulations to Janet for her marvelous collection. And it's a very special thing for me as well to have been part of the magic.
Very cool. But that's not all. Our friend Floyd, in exchange for the Swatch Watch, Janet has sent a personalized,
oh wow,
hand-drawn, hand-painted, just special. especially for you, Janet. So here's the question. You want to make the trade?
Aye, aye, aye.
Coming up on Collector's Call at Home Edition. Janet's all ears after seeing what Kate has to offer for their trade deal.
It's crazy. This is crazy. I wasn't expecting.
Janet's the leader of the club when it comes to Mickey Mouse collectibles. But after seeing Kate's trade offer, an autographed Mickey drawing by a famous Disney animator, Janet has to decide if she can bear to say bye-bye to one of her prized possessions.
Janet, what's going through your mind right now?
Blank.
Floyd really is a legend in the world of Walt Disney.
I just didn't know it was going to be so special. It's crazy. This is crazy. I wasn't expecting this.
I can't believe she's hesitating. What are you thinking, Janet? You have over 100 watches. This is a one-of-a-kind. What is it about that that would be difficult to let go of for such a treasure?
I'm going to tell you. This watch, my father-in-law, his father, gave it to my daughter.
See?
No, I can't do this. I can't do this. I can't. Thank you, Floyd. I appreciate it, but I can't part away from this watch. This is a very special watch that my daughter really enjoyed.
Kate, she has over 14,000 items. Is there anything else that you may want to make in trade?
Janet, send me a keychain. I'm happy to send this.
Do you want me to write my name on it?
I want your autograph.
Oh, perfect.
The watch should stay with your collection.
It's going to mean the world to me to have this print now.
That's amazing.
My goodness, that is wonderful. It is a very happy call.